the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God the Father, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Dear friends, welcome to this 11th Sunday during the year. And in the readings today, we hear that God shows himself a people. In fact, he chooses also us, and in order to be his, we have to obey his laws and do what he wants us to do. So let us ask him during this Mass that we may really do what God wants us to do in order that we can be really his people. And for the many times that we have done our own will and not the will of God, we ask him now for forgiveness. I confess to Almighty God
and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
And may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us all our sins, and bring us to eternal life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Gloria in excelsis Deo. Et in terra pax
And let us pray. O God, from whom all good things come, graciously hear our pleas, And since without you, mortal frailty can do nothing, grant us always the help of your grace, that in following your commands we may please you by our resolve and our deeds. We make this our prayer through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen. The first reading. A reading is taken from the book of Exodus. In those days, when the people of Israel came into the wilderness of Sinai, they encamped in the wilderness, and there Israel encamped before the mountain. And Moses went up to God, and the Lord called him out of the mountain, saying, Thus you shall say to the house of Jacob, and tell the sons of Israel, You have seen what I did to the Egyptians, and how I bore you on eagle's wings and brought you to myself. Now therefore, if you will obey my voice and keep my covenant, you shall be my own possession among all peoples, for all the earth is mine, and you shall be to me a kingdom of priests and a holy nation. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorial Psalm. We are his people, the sheep of his flock.
We are his people, the sheep of his flock.
Cry out with joy to the Lord, all the earth. Serve the Lord with gladness. Come before him, singing for joy.
We are his people, the sheep of his flock.
Know that he, the Lord, is God. He made us. We belong to him. We are his people, the sheep of his flock.
We are his people, the sheep of his flock.
Indeed, how good is the Lord, eternal his merciful love. He is faithful from age to age.
We are his people, the sheep of his flock.
Second reading. A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brethren, while we were yet helpless, at the right time, Christ died for the ungodly. Why? Why one will hardly die for righteous men, though perhaps for a good man one will dare even to die. But God shows his love for us in that while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us. Since therefore we are now justified by his blood, much more shall be saved by him from the wrath of God. For if while we were enemies, we were reconciled to God by the death of his Son, much more now that we are reconciled, shall we be saved by his life. Not only so, but also rejoice in God through our Lord Jesus Christ, through whom we have now received our reconciliation. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Alleluia, alleluia.
Alleluia, alleluia.
The kingdom of God is at hand. Repent and believe in the gospel.
Alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
At that time, when Jesus saw the crowds, he had compassion for them because they were harassed and helpless like sheep without a shepherd. Then he said to his disciples, The harvest is plentiful, but the laborers are few. Pray therefore the Lord of the harvest to send out laborers into his harvest. And he called to him his 12 disciples and gave them authority over unclean spirits to cast them out and to heal every disease and every infirmity. The name of the 12 apostles are these. First, Simon, who is called Peter, and Andrew his brother. James, the son of Zebedee, and John, his brother. Philip and Bartholomew, Thomas and Matthew, the tax collector. James, the son of Alphaeus and Thaddeus. Simon, the Canaanite, and Judas Iscariot, who betrayed him. These 12 Jesus sent out, charging them, go nowhere among the Gentiles and enter no town of the Samaritans, but go rather to the lost sheep of the house of Israel, and preach as you go, saying, the kingdom of heaven is at hand. Heal the sick, raise the dead, cleanse the lepers, cast out demons. You received without pay, give without pay. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Dear friends, in the first reading and in the Gospel, we hear that Jesus chose for him people to continue his work. In the first reading, in fact, we hear that he chose the 12 tribes of Israel. And he tells them that if they want to be his people, they will have to listen to him and keep his commandments. In the Gospel, Jesus first shows us his mercy and compassion with those people who are like destitute, who have nobody to help them. And then he chooses his 12 apostles and sent them. And I hope you realize he does not force them. He chooses them. He invites them. And that is God's great love for us. He leaves us free. He does not compel us. And that is, as somebody said once, if we understand it not wrongly, that was God's biggest mistake, to give us our freedom so that we can refuse his love. And in fact, that is the biggest sign of God's love for us, that he lets us free. He doesn't want us to be puppets. He wants us to be independent people, and we can choose for him or against him. So never underestimate your freedom, and please try not to use your freedom in the wrong way. Then afterwards, the funny thing is, he chooses his 12 disciples. First, he says you have to pray that God may send laborers into his harvest. And then he says to them, you go and do this. And if we look at the 12 disciples, it is quite a mixture. They are ordinary people, as we know, fishermen. There is even a tax collector. There is also a guy who was what we would say nowadays, a revolutionary. He was Simon the Canaanite. And then, of course, Judas Iscariot. And I would say if those people who with so many different backgrounds, they came all together only for one thing, for their love of Jesus. Because normally, if the Jews would have lived together with the tax collector, they most probably would have killed him because he was impure in their sight. And Simon the Canaanite, he was the one who wanted to liberate, that the Messiah liberated the Jews from the Romans. But all together, they form one group because of the love of Christ. And Jesus, as we see, he didn't choose himself scribes and Pharisees who were very learned people. He chose ordinary people. He chose ordinary people because he knew that with his help, these ordinary people could do extraordinary things, as we see throughout the whole gospel. And that is just also another facet of Jesus. He does not only see what we have in us, he sees also what, with his help, can come out of us. So therefore, dear friends, let us never oppose God's grace and God's help for us, because it is there that we can become better people. Never mind how poor we are, never mind how destitute we are. If we trust in his love, we can also do many things and great things. And the last thing I want to say is that it is amazing that in the gospel there, really, Jesus shows us that he needs human beings. He needs men and women to continue his work. Therefore, he tells his disciples, pray the Lord that he may send people into his harvest. Even today, God needs us to continue his work. The big question is, are we ready to do it? Amen.
Amen.
And let us now profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty,
maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten and not made, consubstantial with the Father, through him all things were made, for us men and for our salvation. He came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son was adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
And let us now offer our petitions to God, our Heavenly Father. And let us pray first of all for those people who are in government in the church, that they may always realize their responsibility to help the people to proclaim and continue the work that Jesus came to do on this earth, and that they themselves may give the example. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
As Jesus first told his disciples to pray to God to send laborers into his harvest, and afterwards he sends him out to do it, which means that prayer should always go into actions. Prayer alone, words alone are dead. As we know also in the Gospel somewhere, when Jesus said, it is not those who say, Lord, Lord, who will enter the kingdom of heaven, but those who do the will of my Father. So let us always make sure that our prayers continue in our actions. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Let us now pause for a moment and offer our own personal intentions. God, our Heavenly Father, we thank you because you loved us so much that you let us free to choose our own way. You don't force us, you don't want us to be puppets, you want us to be people who can make choices for their own. We have prayed now that we may always do your will, and we ask you this in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
By the mystery of this water and wine, may we come to share in the divinity of Christ, who humbled himself to share in our humanity. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Lord God, we ask you to receive us and be pleased with the sacrifice we offer you with humble and contrite hearts. Lord, wash away my iniquities, cleanse me from all my sins. And pray now, brothers and sisters, that this, my sacrifice and yours, may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and the glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy Church.
Amen. O God, who in the offerings presented here provide for the twofold needs of human nature, nourishing us with food and renewing us with your sacrament, grant, we pray, that the substance they provide may not fail us in body or in spirit. We make this our prayer through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just. Our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For when your children were scattered afar by sin, through the blood of your Son and the power of the Spirit, you gathered them again to yourself, that the people, formed as one by the unity of the Trinity, made the body of Christ and the temple of the Holy Spirit, might, to the praise of your manifold wisdom, be manifest as the Church. And so, in company with the choirs of angels, we praise you, and with joy we proclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, O Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy, and you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord,
until you come again.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, Butit Lachari, our Archbishop, the Order of Bishops, all the clergy, religious, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned here before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we now dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven,
hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and saved from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
And the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And may this mingling of the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ bring eternal life to us who receive it. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. An act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Amen.
Our blessing cup is our communion in the blood of Christ.
Our blessing cup is our communion.
Of salvation, I will take up and I will call upon the name of the Lord.
Our blessing cup is a communion in the blood of Christ.
Our blessing cup is a communion in the blood of Christ.
Taste and see, taste and see the sweetness of
communion in the blood of Christ.
Our blessing cup is a communion.
There is one thing I ask of the Lord, only this do I seek, to live in the house of the Lord all the days of my life. And let us pray. As this reception of your Holy Communion, O Lord, foreshadows the union of the faithful in you, so may it bring about unity in your church, We make this our prayer through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass is ended. Go in peace.
Thanks be to God.
And don't forget, God wants you to help him to continue his kingdom here on earth. Have a nice Sunday.
Thanks, Father. Thank you.
You who dwell in the shelter of the Lord, who abide in his shadow for life, say to the Lord, my refuge, my rock in whom I trust, and he will raise you up.
God forgave my sin. In Jesus' name, I've been born again. In Jesus' name, and in Jesus' name, I come to you to share His love as He told me to. He said, freely, freely, you have received. Freely, freely give. Go in my name, and because you believe, others will know that I said, freely, freely, you have received.